Good morning, students of 11th commerce. In today's class, we will discuss about production possibility curve and how it is related to central problem of an economy. Just remember, in the last class, we discussed about central problem of an economy, like what to produce, how to produce, and for whom to produce. So, today we will discuss with the help of production possibility curve, which is also called production possibility frontier. Frontier is synonym of frontier, boundary. And with the help of PPC or production possibility curve, how we can solve or understand better the central problem of an economy, like what, how, and for whom to produce. Before that, and because we are going to deal with a curve, and hardly you have dealt with curve in your previous classes, that's why we need a little bit of discussion regarding what is a curve and what is its function, why it is useful in the study of economics. In fact, later you will deal with hundreds of different curves. That's why you need to understand the basics of a curve. So, you can see here, we have got five different points, point A, B, C, D, and E. So, if we draw a line and join all these points so that on a straight line all points will come, then this line will be called the locus of these five points. Once again I repeat, locus, L-O-C-U-S, locus, or joining. So, here we can see that AE is a straight line on which point A, B, C, D and E, five different points falls. So, AE is a line or a curve. So, there is no difference between a line and a curve. And it is the locus of all these five points. Hence, what we understood by the word curve, a curve is the locus of different points. So, if we see further, then we can find some lines are straight in nature and some lines are curvy. So, straight lines are also called linear lines or linear curve, whereas these lines are called non-linear line or non-linear curve. So, what makes the difference, we will discuss just after a little time. So, all of you understood that, what is a curve? Curve is a locus of different points. Thus, what is the function of either a linear or a non-linear line or curve in the study of economics? In your previous class, you have already, all of you have studied coordinate geometry. Just try to remember. And here, a little bit of knowledge of coordinate geometry is needed. So, what is a point? It is a basic concept in geometry. And we cannot exactly define what is a point, rather than we can feel, we can understand by looking at it. What is a point? It is, we are not able to define it, but we can see that point, this is a point, and we can name it A. So, what this point stands for? In the study of economics, we deal with the different points. So, what is the importance of points in the study of economics? That, in order to understand that, we need to understand coordinate geometry. And all of you know that, if a plane, on a plane, if we draw two intersecting lines, then we are getting four quadrants. 1, 2, 3, and 4. The point of intersection of both the line is called the point of origin, where
वैल्यू ऑफ बोथ एक्स एंड वाई इज जीरो. दिस इज लाइन वाई वाई वन एंड दिस इज लाइन एक्स एक्स वन. बोथ आर इंटरसेक्टिंग एट पॉइंट जीरो वेयर द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स एंड वाई बोथ इज जीरो. सो नाउ यू सी जस्ट ट्राई टू पुट वैल्यूज ऑन डिफरेंट पॉइंट्स ऑफ द लाइन 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 एंड डाउनवर्ड्स इट विल बिकम -1, -2, -3, -4, -5 एंड सो ऑन एंड सो ऑन. हियर ऑन द अदर हैंड अलोंग विथ लाइन वाई द राइट साइड विल शो द पॉजिटिव पॉइंट्स वेयर एज द लेफ्ट साइड विल शो द नेगेटिव वैल्यूज. हेंस दिस इज 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, this is 5 and so on. And here it is -1, -2, -3, -4, -5 and so on. So this is the basics of coordinate geometry. So what is a point? On this point we can pick any, on this plane we can pick any point. You see, for example, we took point A here. So, point A can be understood with two values of X and Y. X and Y. And what is the value of X at point A? It is 4. And what is the value of Y at point A? It is 3. Thus, what we got is that point A can be explained with a pair of value corresponding to x and y axis. So, is it now clear that any point can be recognized with the help of a pair of value of x and y? So, after understanding this, what about point B which lies on a straight line x? Point B, where the value of x is 4, the value of y is 0. That means value of y is 0 and value of x is 4. So, with a pair of value that is 4 and 0 that correspond to x and y, we can recognize point B. This is all about, we just need to know this much about a point and how we assign a pair of value to a point to recognize it. In fact, in very few concepts, we need more than one quadrant to study a curve, and the maximum of our discussion and curves will fall in quadrant one only, where the value of x and y both are positive. So this is quadrant one, where it is the value of x and it is the value of y. Here is the point of origin. And here we will try to study first a linear line that is AB. And why it is linear? To understand a linear line, first of all we need to understand what is marginal opportunity cost, that is MOC. Or marginal rate of substitution, that is MRS. You can see, in economics we have already studied that our budget is limited and our resources are also limited. That's why, suppose we are going to produce two different goods X and Y. And what point AB shows? Point AB is the locus of numerous points that each point will tell us about a combination of X and Y. As from above we go on towards point B, what we find is that here we are X from A, we are producing this much of Y and this much of X. Suppose our economy needs to produce more of X, then what it will do? It will simply produce more X if and only if he sacrifices the production of some Y. Our budget and resources being limited, if we want to produce one goods more what we were producing previously, then we have to sacrifice the other goods. So the rate of this substitution is nothing but MOC or MRS. MOC stands for marginal opportunity cost, whereas MRS stands for marginal rate of substitution. So here you see, when we are traveling from point A to point C, what is happening? That we are sacrificing this much Y in order to produce this much of more X. So this is del Y, means a change in the quantity of Y that was previously produced, and this is del X, the quantity of X that how much we want to produce more. That's why marginal opportunity cost or marginal rate of substitution gives us the ratio between del Y and del X. So MOC or MRS is nothing but the ratio between del Y, means the change in quantity of Y, and del X is the change in quantity of X. So this is the concept of MOC. So now we will see what exactly is happening when we have got a linear curve and we have got a non-linear curve. Side by side we draw both the curve so that our understanding will be better. This is one linear curve or linear straight line, whereas this is a non-linear curve or non-linear line. You can see the line, the belly of the curve is protruding outside. Sometimes you may get a curve where the belly of the curve is protruding inside. So remember two names here. This is called a curve convex to the origin, and this curve, this type of curve where the belly is protruding outside, is called concave to the point of origin. convex to the point of origin and concave to the point of origin. Later, we will see that when we start studying production possibility curve, we will find such a curve that is concave to the origin, point of origin. Perhaps in some other concepts like IC or indifference curve, we will find that the curve will be convex to the point of origin. However, first of all, the basics we need to understand that what is happening when a curve is straight line or linear, and what is happening to what? What is happening to MOC or MRE, marginal rate of strain or marginal opportunity cost? How it is behaving in case of a linear line, whereas in case of a non-linear line? So first we will see a linear line. So you see here, in order to produce one more x, the amount of y we are sacrificing, that is del y upon del x, the ratio is almost constant throughout. You can see here how much y we sacrifice, almost the same amount of y we are sacrificing in order to produce one more unit of x. Here also with the same amount of y we are sacrificing in order to produce one more x. Hence, the ratio between del y or change in the quantity of y and del x, that is change in the quantity of x, which is nothing but marginal opportunity cost or marginal rate of exchange, is remaining almost constant. It is equal to k. K stands for a constant value. If suppose it is 1 by 2, then it will be big. It will be the same 1 by 2, 1 by 2 and 1 by 2. Hence, del y upon del x is constant in case of a linear curve. Once again I repeat, in case of a linear curve, marginal opportunity cost or marginal rate of exchange is a constant value. Now we will see what is happening to MOC or MRE when the curve is non-linear. We know that the curve is concave to the origin. Now here, to produce one more x, this much y we sacrifice. And further, if you want to produce one more x, now we need to sacrifice more y than how much we have sacrificed previously. Here, again, in order to produce one more x, still more y we need to produce. Hence, what we can conclude? That del y upon del x, the value of del y is going on increasing and increasing and increasing, whereas the value of del x is almost same. So what we can conclude here? That suppose this is first 1 by 2, then the other value will be 2 by 2, then the other value will be 3 by 2. So what we can say? What is happening to these fractions? That the value of each fraction is going on increasing and increasing and increasing. So we can conclude that in case of a non-linear curve, not in all non-linear curves, but such a non-linear curve where the MOC, where the slope, this is also called the slope of a curve, where the slope is came to the origin, then what is happening to MOC or MRE? The value of MOC, marginal opportunity cost, or marginal rate of exchange is going on increasing and increasing and increasing. So, later we will see that the shape of a production possibility curve is concave to the origin, and while discussing all the delicate points of production possibility curve, we will discuss that why the value or the slope of the curve or MOC of the curve or MRE of the curve when it is concave to the origin is going on increasing and increasing. What exactly is the reason? We will study just after a little time.
This is the typical production possibility curve which is concave to the origin. And what here we are doing, point A, point B, point C and point D is explaining different combination of two different goods. You can see here a production possibility curve never touches either axis, either x axis or y axis. And if it is touching, then what is happening? Exactly that one value is positive, whereas the other value is zero. That means we are producing, not producing two goods, two different goods, but we are producing only one good. But we have already taken the assumption, we have already assumed from the beginning that the economy is producing two different goods X and Y by employing all its productive resources. So the production possibility curve can touch neither axis. And before going further, we just have a little discussion on the assumption of production possibility curve. The note I have sent to you, everything is written in detail in the notes section as well as in the question answer section. So not everything I am writing here except the curve only, and here all the assumptions just orally we will discuss, and I will not be writing in detail all the assumptions. So the assumptions are, first of all, that when we are producing two different goods, obviously some sort of technology we are following, and technique of production, remember last class, it might be a labor intensive technique of production, or it may be a capital intensive technique of production. So whatever may be the technique of production, it remains unchanged. We have assumed that the technology of production while studying an indifference curve is remaining constant. So what will happen if the technology changes? So there can be two different possibilities. The technology can be better or the technology can deteriorate. So in case the technology is getting better, the curve, and in case it is deteriorating, the production possibility curve will sink downward to its left. So we don't need such type of changes. That's why in the beginning itself we assumed that the technique of production, while studying the production possibility curve, the technology of production is not changing. Second, all the productive resources of the economy is fully and efficiently utilized. Here two terms to be taken care of, that full utilization of resources and efficient utilization of resources. I can explain with the help of an example. Something is employed means it is being able to earn something because he has got some caliber or some value or some skill. But is the skill fully utilized? That depends upon whether it is efficiently utilized or not. For example, if we have got a doctor, and if we allow him or employ him to treat people, then it is fully and efficiently employed. But if we employ a doctor to work as a cook in a hotel, then of course he is employed. There is full utilization, but it is not efficient utilization. So in the very beginning, we have already assumed that all the productive resources of the nation is fully and efficiently utilized. Second to it, we are coming to the reason why production possibility curve is concave to the origin, point of origin. That the third assumption, that is, all the productive resources are not equally efficient. What do you mean by equally efficient? Equally efficient means, suppose you have got 10 levers. So, all 10 levers are not equally efficient in a particular job. They have their different difference in their specialization. For example, in a school, 10 teachers are teaching. Some teacher may be more efficient in the teaching of English,
Some might be more efficient in the teaching of mathematics. Some might be more efficient in the teaching of computer science. So these are the difference. And this property is called a resources being use specific. Use specific. Now just try to understand why the marginal rate of substitution is going on increasing and increasing. As we are increasing the production of X every time by a single unit. What happens? You see, in the beginning we are producing this much of X, and for this we are using some resources. And why we used some particular resources to produce X, this much amount of X? Because they are more efficient in the production of X. And in the economy, no other labor is that much efficient in the production of X. So now, this much labor is being utilized for the production of Y. Why? Because they are more efficient in the production of X. Now what happens? When we try to increase the production of X by one unit, then what will happen? Our resources being limited, being fixed, we need to withdraw some resources from the production of Y to make them work to produce this much of X. And remember always that the resources that we are bringing to produce X from who were earlier producing Y, they are not that much efficient to produce X because they have a specialization in the production of Y. However, they can up to a level, they can produce X also, but they will not be equally efficient. So, in the first point, this much Y was needed to produce one more X. In the second point, we need more Y to produce this much X. Why? Because they are not specialized in the production of X, but they are specialist in the production of Y. That's in this way, the resources which are used to produce Y, we are withdrawing resources to produce X. So the resources that can be better produce X will go on decreasing and decreasing and decreasing. And as a result, what will happen? If we continue to increase the production of X, we need more, still more X, more Y to produce one more unit of X. This is the reason why production possibility curve is concave to the point of origin. So, the reason is that if someone asks you why production possibility curve is concave to the origin, your simple one-liner answer will be because resources are huge specific. They have different specialization, and all resources cannot perform the duty of producing all the goods and services equally efficiently. So this is not the discussion of PPC is not yet finished, but the class time is over. So we'll stop here for today. And I remind you, just ask me in case any doubt you are getting, and go through the diagram, try to understand the diagram, try to understand the concept, and if getting problem, please call to me. Thank you and have a nice day.